Hello and welcome to a Twitch VOD replay of my Armstrong Powerhouse Class 40 Whistle Rail Tour Trouble scenario along the Cornish mainline between Plymouth and Penzance. This scenario came around as a challenge from viewers. As some of you may know, you can overheat the traction motors on the AP Class 40. The challenge was to prevent them from to get to Penzance without overheating or overstressing the motors. Some portions of this video may be muted due to requested music being played by the Twitch viewers, as this was an active Twitch live stream, but chat and conversation is at the top of the screen for you to join in on. The scenario has been finished, and it has been finished with text and certain AI changes since this video. The scenario at the time was in a simple test stage. The scenario is now available for download on UK Train Sim with a link below in the description. As always, any feedback is appreciated, and I hope that you do enjoy this video. Let's try this again. Try not to spend an absolute age dicking about in this station this time. I'll just get in and out. And there's a shunt signal. Hey, look at that, it works. Shocker. To wreck the traction motors before we even get into Plymouth.
Yeah, blow the motors as we get into Plymouth.
I was in London. Well, you can't say you were lying. I had a friend come over, he's from Brisbane, and he was giving us the rundown of everything. He was doing like a tour of Europe. He chose the right bloody time to do it. He'd be buggered if he tried to do it now. I know what you mean. I know what it is. Just getting, is this big enough for the, is this too big for the platform? I know on some lines this 40 clips through the platform, doesn't it? Believe right, you've got all these AP coaches here, and the passenger view it gives me is A, right at the back, and B, out the window. Yeah, hey Chris, how are you? Yeah, no, he's metal. I'll need one of them soon and all, I think. Fire up TeamView and let Rob drive the train while I go for a drink.
I'd blow it up before par.
Compact, you fucking would just to piss me off.
Well, I got to par. What's the problem? Look at the engine.
Why are all the bogeys missing? Do you know what? I've not yet failed the traction motor on a 40. Not on the SAP scenario. Not on any of the other scenarios I've done. I've not even in like the three test runs of this I've done, I've not yet blown one of these up. Every single time I've been halfway through it and then something's happened, which meant I've not been able to finish it. Yeah, bless him. That's it, now he's recovering, so we all wish him a happy recovery stage. I said to him, said in his recovery period now, Cyanide's got to get his streaming game in. He's got to start just hammering the streaming now. Ramp up Annie's internet bill. Ding-a-ling-a-ling. Oh, excuse me. Might be a bit of yawning tonight, sorry. Unless I go and have a sneak, in which case I'm fine. Do you know, for the first time today in a long time, I got hiccups. I don't think it is it? Oh, it is Annie at the disco. Oh yeah, of course it is.
It's Annie at the disco.
Yeah, it is, yeah. Go on then. Who looked at the Facebook? No, thanks. Thanks, Steam fan. Best disco moves. And I get the jam out.
Best thing about Two for Tuesday is there's always pizza for tomorrow.
I wouldn't leave any. Crawling up the hill. Come on! You can do it! Excuse me.
Choo choo!
You've got wheels, why are you so slow? Welcome back. start picking up speed now, which is great because then we're approaching 15 mile an hour at the bottom.
Don't break the loco this time.
I mean, technically, I didn't break it last time. Ring-a-ding-a-ding. Hey, we're at 40. This feels really fast.
Yep.
And knock it all off again in a minute when it's because we start climbing again. They weren't keen on making it a flat line, were they?
Too many hills in Cornwall.
There is metal. We can't use some of the water out the boiler to cool down the traction motors with. Bit of cheeky water cooling. No tour deck, mine. This was set as a challenge. Well, I had set it up for people so people can use it as a challenge. It's also a challenge for me. Because this class 40, if you didn't know, has, see the little green dots? So they're all the traction motors. So you can break a traction motor, basically, if it gets too hot. So the gauge on the right here is the temperature gauge. You can break these. Now this is quite a long, heavy loco. Well, quite a long, heavy train consist. And this isn't offering any power, neither. Tune. The brother's gonna work it out. The brother's gonna work it out. Yes! I've already been intrigued by your colleague's persistence earlier. I so want it.
Two in one night, wow.
And I'm really pulling numbers tonight. The brother's gonna work it out. The brother's gonna work it out. So yeah, you can basically break this engine. You basically break a class 40. Hi, Diva. So the mission is to get a long consist hauled by a class 40 over to Penzance without breaking too many things, not to be able to make it. I think sums it up pretty well. How are you, Diva? Hope you're well. Speeding is a way in which you can avoid blowing out. Can we make it three? I don't know. I reckon we'll get another one in. Welcome back, Mel. Nothing's about me, nope. Nothing's about me. So yeah, that's the challenge. Because the Cornish mainline is long and quite lumpy. I've just noticed the Union flag house down there. I'm hoping they'll sort it for you. I'm sure they will. Plug the Union Jack house. See, that would be clever if the Union Jack wasn't just a flag that was thrown at sea on the front of Her Majesty's merchant naval vessel. Oh, Diva. Oh, well, I really hope it doesn't come to that.
Oof.
No, I'm so sorry, Diva. Hopefully it doesn't come to that.
My guess is you got undercut then. Company says
yeah, I'm good, thank you, Avro. How are you? The voice you can hear is the voice of reason in my consciousness. Mr. KTL Rob Powell. It's who that is. So I think it's Alicia. Oh, I'm so sorry to hear it. You're alright, you guess. No, we don't like guesses. You're either all right or you're not all right. That could be nice. It could be a nice little chapter. Evening, Mars. How you doing? We are in Discord if you fancy jumping in. You have to let me know. Big bag of
chocolate. Don't blame your naked either.
Fucking crack on with it. Honestly, if yeah. I could sit here and have a... Okay, no worries, Mus. Honestly, Dave, if I could sit here with a big bar of chocolate, Ben and Jerry's and a beer, I'd quite happily do that right now. What would you look at doing, if you don't mind me asking? What tickles your fancy?
See, your Cornish mainline looks all shiny and nice because you haven't got the settings down on absolute bottom.
I don't know about shiny and nice, but yeah, there's a certain element of that.
Did you set this in spring?
Yeah. If I was being really evil, I could have done it in winter.
Wheel slip.
Yeah. Not only are we going to overheat the traction motors, we're also going to fuck the rails. To be a sad man. And blue eyes. Go for it. It's the iBird, the binge who's drinking bigots. It's the iBird, they're the worst bird. It's the iBird, binge who's drinking rags. It's the iBird, they're the worst birds. Still enough to write things out for a while. Yeah. I suppose, especially in this climate, you just keep hold of what you can, don't you? Robert Miles' Children Eat Me edit. If that doesn't scream weirdo, I don't know what does. An Eat Me edit of Children. You alright? No, I do like that song. So if it fucks it up, I'll be more than displeased.
And remember, you don't need the entire YouTube link to get the song request in.
No, you only need that bit of it. I want to go back outside and watch the train like zoom, but last time I did that in this region of the Cornish mainland, it fucked me up. Hi Katav, how you doing? Yeah, my day's good, thank you. How's yours? I was busy. Tired, because I didn't get to sleep so late last night. Welcome to the Class 40 on the Cornish Main Line. Not so good, a little bit tired. Is it just tired, or are you good apart from being tired? I hope you are. Of course I do. You were in here not long ago. St. Germans. Ironically enough.
Man.
Go on, give us a native pronunciation.
St. Germans.
Alright, fair enough.
Home of the Church of St. Germain.
St. Germain, isn't that a football team in Paris? Paris Saint-Germain. PSG.
No, that... Yeah, PSG is Paris Saint-Germain, but this is Saint... as in Saint-German. As in... Cheeky fuck.
That's puzzled you, hasn't it? That's got you.
Cheeky fuck.
I could hear the smile developing as you sat there working out going, oh yeah. Now, if you do this bit too quick as well, you end up waiting at this signal. So that's why you just take this scenario quite slowly. Because if you rush it, you sit at this signal. This could be Rotterdam or anywhere. You got punched. Oh, got banned. You got banned to ETS too. You got a 2-day ban on ETS. Oh, I'm sorry that you got punched. Hopefully it wasn't. Hopefully you didn't start something. You went up to somebody and like on TV during music videos. Yeah, it's fine. Fine metal. I can watch the music videos. I'll stick them on stream if it's wide. But if it's wise. Well, hopefully the punch wasn't too bad for you. If it wasn't bad at all, then I'd say stop moaning. But
that two ETS2 bans must have been something minor for a 2-day ban.
What did you do for an ETS2 ban? If you don't mind me asking, what did you achieve? Do you reckon we'll make it 70 miles?
You're not overtaxing the engine.
No, I've been quite. Had to punch back. Well, you defend yourself. 1 in 74, this is really killing it. The peoples are pickles for sure. What did you do on ETS to receive a 2-day ban? Eight drops away. Oh, is this your card? This card's 8 drops away. Oh, come on, Jenks. Come on, Jenks. He's going to open it.
We know he got into a punch out at school. This, what did he do to get banned on ETS2?
Yeah, his message was... You drove through a red light in Calais, that'll do it.
Yeah, that'll get you a 2-day ban.
Reckless driving.
Yeah, that's an automatic. If you're caught by an admin doing that, that's an automatic 2-day ban minimum.
Which is why I always say, drive as you should, not as we do. Because we're good at it.
In populated areas, we always obey the traffic signals. Not that everybody does, but...
It's really confusing if you're talking about ETS and you start going on about ATS. And they're like, well, I'm on about Eurotruck, I'm on about Eurotruck. And I'm like, yeah, I am. ATS stands for Automatic Traffic Signals. Which is the official term for a traffic light. Are you excited, Jenks?
Yeah.
Come on, Captain.
Calais ping. Come on, Captain. Get that graphics card in your system and see if it works.
I want you joining us on Discord tonight, here. On your new ripped out super mining computer.
Yeah, if you cause an accident jumping a red in Euro Truck multiplayer, you can get up to, I think, a 2-week ban for reckless driving.
I think they can give you up to a month, can't they? If they so choose.
Yeah, if they so choose, they can give you a month for it. So 2 days is a very light ban.
Bear with us a minute, Kyle. What's the flashing light that's ever lollipop? No, I don't know. I've not a fucking clue. You're the professional driver here, not me. Can sub you. Oh, okay, well, thank you very much if you do, but you know that you never have to. Don't feel like you have to, because you don't.
Too easy, Captain. It's a Belisha beacon.
Rob, get off Google.
Don't need Google for a Belisha beacon.
Hello.
Hi, Kyle. Sorry, I didn't see you sat there. How you doing? Because I don't look at Discord normally unless somebody says, I'm in Discord. That's why I get 5 messages from Rob, and he's like, I'm here.
I'm here. And then in chat, hashtag shout. You're like, just start shouting. You're like, oh.
Yeah. Start shouting. Yeah, but not. I'm just time you out.
I'm not that clever, Captain.
I really want to watch Devil's Lips. I know, yeah. None of us ever do. I got to sleep. You have school. What time is it where you are, or, Katev? Welcome to the 30 mile an hour rail tour of the Cornish mainland.
At this rate, it'll only take us till midnight to get there.
That's fine, that's what I'm aiming for. No worries, Metal. Are you off now, or have you got a bit to go yet? You said 8 o'clock, didn't you? It's about now. It's 7 p.m. where you are. Katev, well, if you need that much sleep, mate. I got 4 hours sleep last night, and here I am. Pelican Puffin, Toucan, Pegasus.
What's the fuck? I got Pegasus? About 6, but that was broken. I had a bad nightmare.
Yeah. Did you involve a class 50 going off a cliff?
No.
Oh. Train sim out of memory and at the end of a 12-hour run.
Train sim out of memory and after Wipeout says it's going to crash.
It was a recollection nightmare. No! Are you off metal? Well, thank you very much for being here then, buddy. And you have yourself a good day at work. Bye, Katev. Thank you very much. Thanks for coming in as well. Have yourself a good... Oh, you're not off yet. All right, fair enough. Well, thank you very much, Katev. Thanks for coming in, buddy. You have a good day at school. Oh, you work from home. Ah, right. And you take... You ain't losing me. Well, yeah. Give me time. Give me time. Everyone gets fed up with me in the end. This will be taxing the shadow tries, no bless. Rights of way. Go and ask Saber. I don't want a fucking clue. No, I've never even heard of a Saber crossing. Not a Saber crossing, Pegasus. As far as I'm aware, Pegasus are the automatic traffic signal ones. Oh, the Pegasus you get horses across. So it's a bridle way. Similar to how a toucan then is the automatic traffic signal ones. How would you get up for it? Oh, you will. Promise you. It'll happen. No. We'll take it up with Google, because that's what that says. Toucan is a cyclist. Oh. Yeah, I know Pegasus is a horse, but I didn't know what the Pegasus crossing was. Because I'm thick and don't apply them. Toucan, oh dear. Fuck off, AWS. Civil servant puns. Don't even get him started. Do not get Captain Jenks started, whatever you do. Probably can't quite get away with that then. Just take about 30%. That should be enough to keep us on a low effort trial. I've never been at a set of lights where it holds the red light if someone's crossing, because if you're, well, anywhere I go and cross the road, you'd be waiting for fucking ever. Think of one of them in the middle of Manchester or London. Thinking... They crumb it, I don't know what that means.
Power! Unlimited power!
Don't have power! I'm being so conservative, it's unreal.
Put the power on!
We're coming up to a hill!
Not that much!
Fucking hell. 50. What was 50%?
Uh-oh, might need more. 1 in 96, 1 in 80.
Come on, Rob, I thought you knew this route. I should just max it and then just use it like 90% to try and get airflow through it. I don't know if that actually affects things. I don't know if the quicker I go, the more airflow goes through the radiator, the more it cools.
You've got the vents open, right?
Yeah, I've got the vents open, yeah. Current song. So if you do that until I can. Oh yeah, the old song list. You just come up with a funky algorithm. Just try and find something that fits. Ah, no, that's far too technical for me, that. I tried to code a Raspberry Pi once and gave up on that. I put it together, got the OS working on it, and went, don't know what I'll do now. Just gave it me dad. Fast light, innovative regional train. I thought you were going for FLIR. Flair. Hey! You still there, Alfie? Ah, he's chilling on your laptop. 1 in 74, eh, Rob? 18 miles till par. It's been nearly an hour since I started the scenario. They are fast. If four car units got that much horsepower, I should hope it's quick. I don't know what that one was going to be, but sure, seen him in Toda. Yeah, I'm sure it is. I mean, what's the class 40? 1800 brakes, something like that? If that. 1600? I don't know. I'm just guessing, but... 2000. Lots. It's not enough.
Needs more power.
They just made a 37 fat. Can't, Captain. Can't. Gotta watch them temperatures. Look, there you go. We're already hitting the bottom of the amber and we're not even at par yet.
Yeah. I don't know if there's actually a bug where it overheats quickly.
Hey, Squire, sir. How are you, dear chap?
Been spied on. Change the bulb.
Does that mean we get to use the red bulb? Yes, part of the red bulb.
Are you sure? That means that we have to change the bulb.
Pull out the red bulb. This is an emergency. Are you sure, sir? How you doing, Squire? Are you well? Good to see you. Thank you very much for the raid. I'm guessing Alfie had something to do with it, did he? This is the Cornwall, the Cornish route, yeah. This is the Cornish mainline.
Which we're going through very slowly.
We're making it. We're doing a rail tour of the Cornish mainline, except we're doing it at 22 mile an hour. As we have a load of 14 behind the class 40. And of course, if anybody doesn't know, you can overheat the class 40. Yeah, well, the class 14 IRL probably doesn't overheat quite as much as this one does. And that's probably working in IRL. Welcome back, Stephen. There you go, speed's on the way up. See, I don't know how the dynamic of the cooling of this works. If I go quicker, is it going to cool better? Or am I better using less power to stop it from heating? But hello everybody, I hope you are well. Thank you so much to Squire for the raid. Though I am rather sure Alpha must have had something to do with it. Saw a 56 the other day. Well, there's quite a few of them about, so.
BRB, another coffee time.
Stop it making me jealous. Got a dry mouth now, I have. How you doing, Sap? You okay? Yeah, I'm trying it where I can. Cornish Rail have been using quite a few 56s around kind of Crewe areas, so taking it from North Manchester through Crewe. How are you, Sap? I hope you're well. I e-cups before, and chat was very quick to tell to show me your e-cups emote. Ah, I almost missed my own do. That should be on. I don't know why it isn't. It should. This isn't downhill for very long. Thanks, Alfie. One in 74 upwards. This would be a way to overheat it. Come on! Get up the hill. Otherwise we'll be here for years. I meant to press F1 to be fair. Yes, Alfie.
Return of the man.
You hear a van. Jenks is glued to his screen.
He wants that graphics card to make sure his machine works.
I might end up doing, Alfie.
Hello, sap.
I'm getting up this one in 68. It's killing me, Rob.
You wait till the climb out of Truro. You're not going to make it if you don't throttle it.
Oh, yeah, I'm stopping in Truro as well. That's, I mean, that's why. Stuck in the double penetration disco mode. What? Ah, okay. Come on. We can make it. Alfie, thanks for the host. Is it because a viewer sent him? Who was? And I was a comedian last night. Oh. No, so that you guys can send me all the bug you like, I'm not eating any. What? If I was to time someone out, is it slash timeout 10 then the name? For 10 seconds. Rob.
Yeah?
If I was to time someone out for 10 seconds, would it be slash timeout 10 then the name?
I can't remember because honestly, the last time I did it, I was using mod panel.
You're safe for now, Legend FIFA. You're safe for now. Ah, the bridge that isn't a bridge.
Have you got your graphics density, your scenery density down?
Not as far as I'm aware.
You must have, because that bridge will be, that bridge is a scenery density 10 item.
Oh yeah, I might have it down, because I think I did turn it down for something. Don't worry about it, Sap. I think it must be, I don't know how it works. Tune. If this is better be the original one, because if it's not, I'm going to be pretty pissed. Just for doing shit things, really, Alfie, if I'm honest. Like yesterday. I'll give you 11,000 bits if you agree to do push-ups. I'm like, go on then. But we're in the middle of Kens and you're going, we'll do your horn and I'll give it you. I'm like, well, you know I can't do my horn. But, so guess who didn't have to do 10, guess who didn't have to do 10 push-ups? Fucking me.
Only 10.
Yeah, that's what it was. Trust me, mate, it'd take me an hour to do that. It wasn't 9, it was 10. Told you, you give us the 11,000 bits you promised, and I'll quite happily do 10 push-ups. Sounds like a pretty good deal if you ask me. Oh, is that it? Thank you, Sap. Hey, you were the one who suggested it, not me. Oh yeah, it does work.
Message deleted by a moderator.
Yeah. It does work.
Now, was that 10 seconds or 10 minutes?
25. 25 seconds.
How come Legend FIFA's been timed out for?
Because...
If you were keeping note of what was going on, you'd know.
Nah.
It was just... Because I can. Nah. The same way, like, to be fair... It now seems that now I'm part of the club, I could also do, Hey, Virago!
Oh no, don't do Virago too.
It's not 25 seconds wasted on me, Alfie. He's not even here, he's driving, I think. Tomorrow morning at 9:30. Does that mean I've got to get in work early to go and get it, to go and see it?
Ooh, an Antonov 124.
Yeah. I'm now passing you, Kipland.
Is that the big one?
No. The big one's 225. The Myra. It's a fair size one.
Yeah, that's not to say a 124 is a small aircraft, is it?
No, definitely not, no. It doesn't fit in the case. Oh, no. What a mare. Oh, look at 158.
No.
It doesn't fit in the case.
This is why I always use big cases.
Oh, Captain. I blame Mozzie.
I blame Mozzie.
There you go. We're blaming Mozzie. Oh, mate. You'll make it fit. How big, how much is it out? What's the
2060 Super's not going to fit in the case.
That is a 2060 Super he's got. We're saving heat now. And we're actually doing line speed.
Let it over speed.
I'm gonna.
Don't forget to press the engine start button once you've moved from engine off. You did shut the engine completely down, didn't you? You didn't just put it in engine off.
No, I just put it in engine off.
That would be why the engine's not cooling down then.
Well, so if my engine stop now, if I completely kill it, how do I restart it now on a roll? Just the engine Z-key. Start.
Hit and hold engine start.
Alright, okay, we'll give it a go. Just to put on a random sheet, it was a bar. That's pretty cool. Cool down your fucking... Oh, it is doing. Haha. Can I feel like a super bike?
Yeah, because engine only leaves it... Because it's not engine off, it's engine only.
Oh, yeah, I know, but I didn't think... I just thought it would just tick over. I didn't realise it made that big of a difference. That is a sick sound. I love that sound. Can you... Yeah, I was going to say, James, can you modify the case in any way? So can you... is there any chance of you being able to remove cages and stuff? Yeah, that's what I was saying. Get a Dremel. Go and get a Dremel cheap one off Amazon. How big's the overlap? Because you might be able to take some off the plastic on the graphics card.
Not advisable, because that's usually holding the heatsink on.
Not advisable, but... I know, innit, Jack? It is. It's a really nice sound when something goes past on, like, no throttle. Oh, yeah, Diva, that's a point. Yeah, try and get a standoff for it. Is there a reason I should be slowing down to 50 here, Rob?
Curve.
Should I slow down?
No, you'd be alright at that sort of speed.
I'll put a little bit on. Yeah, but it's not to say you can't do it. Let's go. Yeah, but my point being, oh shit, at station.
It's about 4 centimeters out, and it's where the drive goes. Time for a new case.
Cases are on the cheap, mate. Hey, look, it's a steam train. Hey, look, it's a HST.
Steam train, HST.
Black fives.
So see? That's the diesel shed.
Oh, I knew something, right? This is why you're here. Well, hang on, if that's where the drive goes, just take the drive cage out and put the drives on the bottom of the case or something. I mean, with some rubber feet on it or something. For static purposes, but just take some out. Come on, you'll be right.
Yeah, it's like, can you remove the drive bay? If answer yes, can you mount the hard drives anywhere else? If answer yes...
Do it. It's riveted in. Fucking rivet it out.
Oh, bollocks. If it's riveted in, don't even bother.
I've fucking done it. Go on, get yourself a file.
If it's riveted in, then don't bother.
Get ready to do some fucking scrap heap challenge.
It's time for a new case. You want a full... For a card like a 2060, you want a full-size case.
Rob, I've currently got Z pressed and it's not starting. Hi, Ed. Hi, everybody.
Sap, you still in the chat? Which setting is it on the reverser to start the engine? Shove it into neutral.
I have got the manual downloaded. I'll have to go and find it though by that time. Oh no, it's starting in neutral. It was in engine only. No, it's... Oh yeah, no, sorry, it was on off. My bad. I thought it was forward, neutral, reverse, engine only. It's not. Oh, behave, Alfie. Hi, yeah, not bad, Tony. Not bad. Doing well, thank you. So, I'm put the card in the micro PC. Okay, so then a Raspberry Pi. Yeah, just get yourself a Raspberry Pi and shove that in there instead. Stop my press. Yeah, there you go. It's on. We're on. There's the 66 waiting for the castle.
Ooh, that's a nice long train.
I'm not ignoring you. Your messages aren't getting deleted, there's nothing wrong. I'm a bit busy driving a train and talking to people at the minute. Nice.
No. A airport in Cornwall didn't close. The airport in Cornwall closed.
Hang on, where did
everything
that come
else
from?
In Cornwall is an aerotrain. Ben saying, did I hear an airport closed in Cornwall? It's like, no, it's not a airport, it's the airport.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Because everything else is an aerodrome. Because there's a distinct difference between an airport and an aerodrome, isn't there?
Hi, Mr. Rogers. Are you well?
Hey, Chris.
It's a flight of fancy. It was Newquay, I believe. No, Newquay, as far as I'm aware, is an actual airport.
Newquay is an actual airport with facilities.
Hi, Shelley, how are you doing? Good to
it
see
has
you.
The minimum.
Everyone's here.
I believe it has the minimum facilities to be called an airport.
Yeah, I think it has, yeah. Night, Captain. Sorry to hear about your graphics card kind of doing a bit of a shitter, but we'll sort you something out.
If you want, Captain.
Well, I can find you some decent cases. Mono Smoko. I can hear it, it's just very quiet. What, were you planning on flying down or something? You're really well. Happy days. Yes, I'm okay, thank you. I'm getting on. Cracking on, you know how it goes. See you later, Alfie. Take care, buddy.
You don't get the train from where the Steam Fan Man lives down to Cornwall. It's way too expensive.
Is it spare, Chris, or are you just telling him what you've got? Give me a cheers. Hang on. Cheers. Not spare. It's not much help to him, then, I'm afraid.
Fortunately, the old cases I've got are all too banged up to be of use.
Stick it on a board of MDF. Who actually needs a case? By the way, it's train 85. Well, yeah, that was fair enough then. It's only temporary, fair enough. Get your channel points and stuff, please. I've just worked on giving you new emotes. You know how fussy you. If I remember correctly as well, you were gifted that sub. And I'm not saying I'm not grateful for it, but you seem to be pulling punches that I don't think you can quite cash in yet, Alfie. How's things anyway, Tony, Shelley? I hope you're all well. Well, I know you said you're doing brilliantly, and I'm glad you are. I hope you're keeping busy. What are you up to tonight? Anyone trucking? Anyone doing anything? I'll hold you to it. Tell you what then, you do that, legend. What do you mean by tokens? I don't know what you mean when you say I've got sub-tokens. That means absolutely nothing. I don't... Are they even a thing? Yeah, the train's probably viable from Bristol. It's definitely not worth flying from Bristol to Newquay. Just a plasmophobia. Nice. I've heard a lot about it. Not played it myself, not got it, so... Sub tokens that you sub with. Does anyone else know what Alfie's on about? Sub tokens that you can use to sub to people with.
No clue on sub tokens.
Are they even a thing?
Must be a new thing.
I have a sub-token guide.
It's only a temporary closure of the airport, mind you.
Oh yeah, until passengers return.
Yeah.
Go from here to Bristol, then train up. That works. Kid's trying to get it in, let's have it.
It's still about a...
Yeah, no, not quite then, Diva. Freaking hell, you're going back. I did then receive a little plaque. Very funny. You remember Fletch Bristol? Yeah, to be fair, the coach is probably a better bet.
Coach is a much better bet.
Yeah.
It's cheaper. It costs about 110 quid to go from Bristol to Penzance.
Go all around the houses, like. Do it on a quid on the megabus.
Probably a lot cheaper in advance, though.
Oh, I'll have to hydrate in a minute, Sat. I'll hydrate when I get into par. As a celebration, because I need to go and fill up my water.
You can take a break at par.
Bristol up to Plymouth every hour, got 40 return. Right. What is that? Is that train or coach?
That's coach, and then it's about £10 from Plymouth.
So it's never reboot a computer. Coach, that's coach, right. See you later, Alfie. Yeah, that's about right. But, to be fair, the fare's fairly straight through roads, aren't they? They're not like
Bristol to Plymouth down the M5 and the A38, basically stopping off at small towns on the way on the coach.
Yeah.
So stopping at places like Taunton, Exeter. Honiton, maybe.
Stops off the junction. Oh, like at the, like the services. Just boots you off at the services. Come and sort yourself out. See you later. It's not strong enough. Oh, that's the worst one I've heard all day. Don't use BeefStew as a computer password. It's not strong enough. Fucking hell.
Bad joke. Time out, please. 10 seconds.
Worthy of a 10 second timeout, I think. Chris, A, he's gone to bed, and B, I don't think that'll achieve anything.
No, the card is...
the card is
whatever's
foobar.
Happened with the ball, we know that the card is foobar. Because one of the ports has gone.
Pull the local up to the signal.
The fact that he got a signal at all on the second card is... on the second slot is a miracle.
That should have got the first... No, I was trying to stop by the signal because that should have got the first coaching. Ah, you see, there you go. That's exactly what I wanted to do. So no, it wasn't an overshoot. I wanted to extend. I even said it on the approach. I want to extend here. Right, I'm going to go and grab a quick drink. I'm just going to splash some water in the glass. Why, you pain in the factor. I've just drank. Yeah, dehydrate. What's called? Oh, fuck off. That one's even worse. But I've heard that one before, so I'm not surprised. Unlimited stock coach, that would be a... ...1.5 stops. I wanted to get half a stop. It either stops or it doesn't. Not someone like you. It's Adele. I thought you said the last one was your last one. 2 minutes stop for a cruise ship. Ah, okay. Is it Mega Coach? Is it Mega Bus? Do you know, I like National Express. The coaches are actually quite nice. I went to Skegness on one, really, through Birmingham, and then across to Nottingham and up, I think. But it was not a bad journey.
But I've done Portsmouth and I've done Middlesbrough.
On National Express? Hello, hello, hello. Here he is. The man, the myth, the killing machine on Battlefield, that is Mr. Danny Wiseman.
You mean the killing field that is Danny Wiseman?
The soul fertilizer of plants in years to come, Mr. Danny Wiseman.
Bless him, he was trying his best.
And to be fair, we were both doing pretty shocking, but it was good fun. We did have a good laugh.
What
and
your snipers in, what are you going to do when they get their snipers in position and just zero you in and you, on your spawn
yeah,
point? You're pretty much screwed.
And he had an exceptional stream, and I think we should all raise glass to Mr. Danny Wiseman, who not only got sub-bombed, but had a pretty amazing following too. So, to Mr. Danny.
Yeah, I think Mr. Jack's raid into him, JP with the sub bombs.
Yeah, he did. He did have an amazing stream, and it was good to see, and really good to be a part of too. It was good to come home and then play some Battlefield with Mr. Danny and his. Can I, Rob? I don't think I'm making this climb out of par.
More power.
That's the express play test leads. Come on, you. Oh, I might just put something in there. That's not the line. The line's back there. Might put something in there. Thanks to Rob for the follow, he says.
Yeah, it would have helped if Twitch hadn't unfollowed me from your channel and I had to refollow. It's literally, I thought I was already following Danny.
Yeah, I'd love to. Short voice and I got little legs. I just quite like that one, Sap. I've not heard that one before. Twitch is a thot. Twitch is such a whore. Come on, Whistler. Oh shit. I accidentally just put it to 100. I was like, no. Do not want that. Do not want that. Do not want that. Pirates here. Well, have you just seen it, Diva? You know, people who dress up with an eye patch and go sailing around on things are, do run it at their own risk. Mate, neither are mine. I was pulling positive KDs at one point on that and I was well happy with myself. First person shooters are not my thing. I am not good at them at all, but I really enjoyed that early, so thanks for having us along. Thanks for playing it with us, because normally, like you say, I wouldn't normally play it with anyone. I'm trying to see if that 47's like... And of course it's Sunderland, Boss, Middlesbrough. Durham, Leeds, Birmingham, Milton Keynes, London, Victoria. I had Timbuktu. Hey Tony, I don't know if you've seen me new one for when it all goes tits up. That's pretty much what that last round was, wasn't it? It was... Just need to check if the new card will fit, and that the case measured so card would fit. No, he didn't. That's the problem he's having. It's not a port issue. It's a problem that his card does not fit into his case. Irrespective of whether or not he measured it, he's got it now, and it doesn't fit. Can you make sense of what the Chow War Buy one is? Other than understanding that today's Tuesday, oh no. I get 3-day weekends now, I'm well happy, but don't start taking it away from me. 300 quid on DVD, why? Yeah, it's a good job you didn't have twitch.tv in your name, innit? Yeah, but it's a bit late for that, Chris, he's got it. It's a bit late to tell him. Just people hiking the price up because they can. Fucking 1 in 64. What's the climb out of Truro? What is the climb out of Truro?
About 3 miles at 1 in 60.
I'm just going to have to vastly attempt to save as much of the engine as I can.
It's a nice long hill down into Cornwall, down into Truro.
Oh, good. Apparently the bar wasn't set high enough. So if it's actually... Look at it, snake. I'm a snake. I'm a snakey snake snake. Short and sharp. This isn't short and sharp, it's long and tall or something. Yeah, there's loads of things he could have done. But he didn't do. And now he's got it. Now, of course, he wants to use it. His easiest option, well, honestly, to be just get a newer case. That is what he should do now, I think. Intel. No. I don't know what he runs actually. I don't know what his system is. I think it might even be, I think he's got a Ryzen. Is it not? Oh, this is 1 in 61 and I'm at 91% throttle. Has an older i7, does he? Oh, okay. I've had to go 100% to try and get it up this hill. It's not the fuel I'm worried about, it's the traction motors I'm burning, Danny. I remember when you used to look at i7s and think, if you wanted something that was powerful, you'd get an i7. And thinking like the i7s were amazing. And now, they're just like, oh, it's an i7. There, I've got a Ryzen 2700X. One in 78, seasonal. Temperature's going through the roof. Yeah, no worries, Danny, mate. Thanks for lurking. Like I say, thanks for coming in and having a chat. Pass me best on to Ethan if you're on with him. Nice. St. Austell. Please tell me now there's a nice steady descent out of St. Austell.
There's a slight ascent and then a descent down the other side.
But I'm only doing 19 mile an hour, Rob.
Well, don't worry, you'll make it.
Cornwall is a bit lumpy, bumpy, innit? Chris is asking if Rob recovered from the weekend charity stream.
Just about.
Yeah.
Kinda.
So, I'm probably saying Rob will be back to normal streaming schedule probably next week, but I don't know.
That's kind of the whole point of this, Mike, is that you can burn out these traction motors, can't you, on the AP40?
Mm-hmm.
So the whole point is to try and get the 40 there. The 47 of the Mac is inactive. There's 12 coaches in between, and as Rob pointed out, the 47 classes is two. So. That looks flat to me. Anything that'll get me off this one in 60. It's Fatal Attraction. Nice. You talk to. Okay, ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
Mm.
All behind a 40. Throttled back to 76% in an attempt to try and save you a little bit until we get to the downhill section. We're just touching the yellow again now, just touching the amber again.
Yeah, I think I had a scenario where you go all the way to Dumfries from
Cool. Hello, St. Austell.
Hi, St. Austell.
Well, she can't do the run without turning the engine off down, does it?
I just remember, like, where I started my scenario. My own 40 scenario was from Stranraer to Dumfries, then part two continues on West Coast Main Line over Shap. We take the final leg of it to Carlisle, where normally an electric loco would take it on to Euston.
Yeah.
I think Sap did one of the parts.
This is a great test to see if you can make it, and then the next one will be, can you make it faster?
Just max it out 100% and leave it. See how far you get. So it was... Well, do you know, funnily enough, Steam fan, I thought about doing it in, like, the Jubilee. Or the Royal Scot, I don't know. Yeah, I think... A really good driver could probably get it there without turning the engine off. It would be about now that you would be struggling if I hadn't turned the engine off. Like, really struggling. Like, I'd start losing traction motors by now. After that one in 60, then this very slow ascent out of St. Austell.
Mm-hmm.
I am accelerating though, which is always good. I see, like I say, I don't know how well it works with.
Yeah, I'm just keeping an eye on the forums to see if when the second update for West Coast Mainline South will drop.
It's interesting, so probably another 2 weeks.
Who knows, they might just send it back again. Further fixes.
Thanks, Diva.
Oh, Captain's posted in Mozzie's General that he's looking at mid towers. If the graphics card doesn't fit in his current tower, it's not going to fit in a mid.
Holy shit. Yeah. Sap, did you ring me?
Was it on Discord or on your phone?
And I've had a random Discord invite from someone who's currently streaming.
Okay.
No idea who that is. So we're passing what I think is the concrete work here, isn't it?
China clay works.
Yeah. Oh, is this it here then, on the right? Clay. After St. Austell. Yeah. Is this China clay, right?
Teddy Dryers.
Yeah, wasn't that abandoned a few years ago?
Well, I've put some hoppers and stuff in there anyway.
I think Teddy Dryers is still active. Let me Google it.
In here from there, here dressing so close to trying to get nothing, so I just said, no, right, come on in then, come on in, I'll do it now. Sorry, I genuinely didn't see you, I've genuinely not seen it. I just looked at Discord then. Sorry, if I'd have seen you, I didn't even see you in chat say that you were in Discord, if you were in there. Hey!
Yeah, it is pretty much decommissioned now.
Yeah. Wasn't it 2010 or earlier?
How are you doing, Cookie?
Hello. How was the movie, Cookie?
I did see you watching something. I didn't see what it was you were watching, if I'm honest. Stupid film, what was it? I'm trying to remember what it was, I genuinely can't remember which one it was actually.
You better not be dissing Good Burger, Cookie. Keenan and Kel. Welcome to Good Burger, can I take your order?
Roots in green. Sorry, Sab, I've genuinely not seen it. Like I say, jump on in now. Jump into one of the channels and I'll drag in.
Nah, I'm joshing Night Cookie. It's a bad movie. It was trying to blag in on the success of the Keenan and Kel TV show and it sucked majorly.
Yeah. I don't know what is like the worst film you've ever watched, Rob. I mean the absolute worst.
I can't repeat that on stream.
Oh.
Why was it Two Girls, One Cup?
None of that fake-ass reactionary shit.
Mr. Hands.
Lost Kingdom 2.
One Man, One Screwdriver.
I've never even heard of.
Begins with human, ends with peed.
Oh, okay, yeah, alright.
And I only watched 5 minutes of it, turned it off and went, what the fuck am I watching?
I've never seen it, you know. I want to, but I've never seen it.
No, you honestly do not want to watch it.
Oh, I do. You saying I don't makes me want to watch it even more.
No, you 5 minutes of it, you'd be like, but this shit, I'm out. That's what you'd be like.
Right.
There's a reason it had a ban. It was banned from cinematic release in this country and nearly didn't get a rating.
As far as it wasn't banned worldwide.
Well, some places always gonna have it, innit? Yeah, you see, this is the thing. I've heard a few people say it's really good. It's like a really good piss take, and some people say it was really scary. But I want to know.
It's not scary. It's just absolutely disgusting.
That makes me want to watch it. And see the old one. Should we watch it? So see if we can find it on like Prime or something. Sit in the Discord, watch it. Of course, all on our independent paid for Prime services. What? Right, okay, right now.
No, wait, you can't do that, chat. You can't do that film on a Prime watch.
Oh, you know what I mean. Right, Night Cookie, have you got Amazon Prime? Actually, I can see on your Twitch that you've got Amazon Prime, but have you got Amazon Prime Video is what I mean.
Nico Diva singing Wookiees, and I'll leave it at that.
One sec. You do. Right, hang on. Sap, come into Discord. I've DM'd you a film. Right. If you watch what I'll watch whatever, mate. I've DM'd Cookie a film. Rob, I'll DM it you too. It was actually not a bad film. Me and Amber watched it thinking it's going to be a big tiss take. And it wasn't. It was actually a really good film. It was a film called Inbred.
Seen it.
Space Boots from Space. Oh, for Inbred. Which one have you seen, Rob?
Inbred.
Yeah, it was a good film, wasn't it? I quite liked it, actually. Because it was none of this mucking about... I was expecting it to be shit, and it wasn't. Mike, I'm going to watch it. So, even less time than Space Boots from Space. Oh dear. Well, we know what Diva's been watching then. Jumping, why is your internet dicking out? Everyone else is watching the stream okay, aren't they, I think?
I was going to say, if you got issues, drop the bitrate, because we've got transcoding tonight, so...
Mike really doesn't like it, does he? Right, hey, I've dropped the bitrate a bit. Hopefully that should be better for you. It's on 4,900 now.
Yeah, even George Lucas disowns the holiday special. That says how much everyone thinks of the holiday special of Star Wars.
Who mentioned that?
Nico Diva. How long can you sit through the holiday special of Star Wars? How long can you stand it before you turn it off?
I've never seen it. If it's on Prime or something, send it me, I'll watch it.
It's buried. You have to go looking for it because it's not even on Disney Plus. It's something that's completely disowned by Lucas.
It's on YouTube. Oh. Oh, he's been dicking out with the Xbox. All right, okay. Hi, Interweb. Yeah, class 40, mate. Looking at pictures was bad enough. What's up with you all?
No, really, it's one of those movies that caused controversy for a reason.
Oh, that makes me want to watch it even more!
Wiki it and then you'll change your mind.
What was it called? Is it Space Boots from Space? Or whatever it's called. What was it?
No, the one that I suggest.
Oh, right. Okay, yeah.
All you need to do is read the Wikipedia page. You go, okay, not watching that.
Oh, no, I've seen the trailers and stuff for Human CP.
Oh, no, if you really want to... Mike, I've got an alternative. If he really wants to watch it, he should watch the South Park episode that took the piss out of it.
I think I've seen it. It's just Turbo B movie, right, okay. I'm so glad these are super elevated curves, because if they wouldn't, then this would be all over the place. How are you, Interweb, anyway? You okay, buddy? Yeah, we've got class 40 on a rail tour.
Damn it. If Facebook. I told you to hide all everything from Met Dan Tips.
I'm going to be catching up to whatever's in front of me at this rate. UKTS on Columpton. Not Midlands way. Oh, Exeter and Tiverton. We'll be on train sim then, won't we? That. What is the fascination with things from outer space?
No, Nico Diva, I have the absolute worst B-movie of all time. Clownado.
Right, no, I can beat that. Sharktopus versus Terry. I'm going to have to look it up, hang on. Because I have watched it. There it is. That was the worst movie. Something with tomatoes. Steady. Eight-legged freaks. That was a great film. Danny. Yeah. Gookie, I think it's safe to say, I think we're disappointed in Dan because he's got an Xbox and not a PC, but never mind. Are you sure you watched the correct Atlantic Rim? Oh, we were talking about this at work. Somebody was going on about Pacific Rim. I was like, and he was saying, yeah, I couldn't watch it when like the other half was around. I was like, just be careful which one you're looking, just be careful of which one you're watching. He was like, yeah, that's a fair point. There's a lot of Hawaiian actors in this. Ah, and he's still gonna got an Xbox. That's poor. I'm only playing. Getting along with that like PC Master Race club, you know.
See, I can get on with Attack of the Killer Tomatoes. B movie schlock. Good funny B movie schlock. The sequels, meh. The original, perfect B-movie. Much like Eight-Legged Freaks, the first of the new wave B-movies.
Love of Eight-Legged Freaks.
Get back!
Shit. Yeah.
Caught it.
I'm trying to find out where this train in front of me has gone.
Probably out through the portal.
Oh, no, he did. Oh, yeah, that was cool. No, I got it to stop in the in the platform in Penzance. Now, you know, I said I wasn't going to put anything in platform 2. I knew there was a reason for that, and that's because that goes into platform 2. Cult classic, Tremors. Never seen it.
Fun fact, Tremors 4, I believe, no, Damn Tremors that. 3, Damn. I believe, was the first movie...
Hagland. It's Hagland, it's Hagland. The queen of Twitch sings herself. It's Hagland. And it's Jack Wit. How the devil are you guys? Good to see you. How is everyone? What were you up to tonight then?
Hi.
Hey, look at that. That's about as intro row as you're gonna get. Hi Kath, how you doing? Or Sheila. Which one would you like to be called? Kath or Sheila? I'm fine, I'm alright, thank you. I'm good, I'm having a good evening. Much better news than curry, first I got a takeaway. Hey, welcome home, Sam. On Allah, is she? On an Allah. What? Am I missing something here? Right, so we're about to see a class 40 absolutely cane it out of Truro. You ready? Started on an alarm. Oh, yeah, I know. What my alerts are, is they're Harrier, the AV8 internal sounds. So, like, all the radar locks and stuff of the Harrier. So, the other day I was flying the Harrier, and one of them went off, and it proper shit me up, because I thought, shit, what's happening now? What's going on now? And it was that. Ended on a low note, so we rage quit. Oh man, sorry to hear it. It's frankly down 100 meters. Oh right, okay. Sorry, time is less. No, don't worry about it. How you doing, Kath? I hope you're well. Hagland, thank you very much for the raid. Jack Wit, hello. Oh, it does. I've done it. Oh, what, you mean got tired and missed left? Well, yeah, I've done that too. But I've also rage quit from things in the past. You ain't the first. You won't be the last. Welcome to a Cornish rail tour in the southern English counties, county of Cornwall, where we have a locomotive here from the 60s, well, from the early than that, 50s, isn't it? With a temperature gauge and a tendency to break if you overstress it. So what we're doing is overstressing it. Yeah, I did. I wonder why it must. Where did it come from, Mike? Where did it fly in from? But thank you so much for the raid, Hagland. It's a hell of a lot. Thank you. It's almost holiday special. Oh, thanks, sir. Flew from Gander. Oh, that'd be why then. Right, I'm giving her all she's got. But I'm not in debt, eh? None of that. Alright, stop. Collaborate and listen. I suspect with a brand new invention, something got a hold of me tightly. Parts of the heartbeat daily and nightly. Will it ever stop? Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and we'll go to the extreme. I rock the mic like a vandal. Turn off the stage and drop like a candle. Dance. Dream dead. Ah, I'm 40. Well, we're really stressing it now. Yo, that's so fantastic. What would you say was a good speed to hit the incline at, Rob? I'm doing 30. Come on, class 40. We're nearly at Penzance. Junk in with a basic kit. No, it's not. But it's not big. It's a sieve. Oh, I'll find it, Donny. With a souped up tempo. I'm on a roll. It's time to go solo rolling. Down to the heck and blow. It's on standby, ready just to say hi. Did you stop? No. I drove on back. Just put the whole baguette in. Oh, That's a. I went to. So there was a Sainsbury's near the school I went to. And I used to go, and people used to come up with like little baguettes. Right? And my depth of perception was shit, right? Hi, I fly planes. But my depth of perception is pretty shit. So I went in, and in front of the door, there was a basket, and it had baguettes in it. What I didn't realise was that the baguette I was buying wasn't this big. It was about this big, right? It was a fucking huge thing. And it was like a quid. So I got it. She was like, "You hungry?" I was like, "Yeah." I mean, fat me. I was like, "Yeah." And so she sold me this bloody massive baguette. And then I'm walking back to school with this baguette in my pocket. So I've got my hand up here walking along like that. Just eating a baguette for my tea. Because I just fancied bread. Cheapest, but most filling lunch I've ever had. That and some chocolate chip cookies and chocolate milkshake. Ooh, Facebook's changed again on my phone. I'm doing 25. Am I going to have to start backing these revs off in a minute, because otherwise it's going to... No. We're about half. Lunch on a budget, yeah, mate. Massive baguette. What more do you
want? It's like literally just the gauge, not the HUD.
Hmm?
Just the gauge.
Oh, yeah, I am doing.
If the gauge says you're only at half, you're fine. You'll be hitting the engine a lot more, but...
It's not bad, actually. Not yet. I mentioned it. Is I happy? I'm glad. I'm glad he's home. Is he absolutely spaced? Also, what did you get? Hold up, Rob. Hey, Mozzie, you lurking? You is still lurking, Mozzie. Which is fine. Just as long as you can hear me. I want you to know that I see you in a highway. I see you doing Iceland in an Iveco, and I'm not there. You've been rumbled, my friend.
You know rumbled. When you've been
rumbled. Get up there. JP's in a caravan. And Mozzie's in an Iveco. Half a baguette filled with bacon. Oh, well, that's another thing. Around the corner from school, there was a pantry. And that was... fajita and halloumi fries. Oh, that sounds amazing. Slip it out of it. Good old boy that lost his horse. Oh, bless him.
You've done well on that climb.
Is this the top now, coming up?
It's the break before the slightly easier climb.
Oh, for fuck's sake. How on earth did steamers get up here? They must have had some pretty big mainline steamers coming up here. We're still in the kind of third quarter of the temperature gauge. Yeah, well, yeah, absolutely. So glad to have him home. I'm just keeping an eye on the amp meter. Come on. Get up the hill. Do you ever do that though? Does anyone ever go down for like toast at like 1 a.m? Go down and put some toast in. Then as it comes up, you sit there and you eat some more and you're like, no, I'm gonna have another couple. Thankfully, I always do it with brown bread. Dumb. I thought you said it was a 1 in 6, it was a 1 in 80. There's a castle back in the day, really? Have a good night, Danny. Thank you very much for being here, mate. Have yourself a wonderful evening. Hope you sleep well, my mate. Thanks for coming in. Good to see you. And an absolutely excellent stream earlier. Have a good one, buddy. I'm gonna have to back off the power, I think, up here. Oh, you are amazing, sir. Thank you very much. No, buddy. To some witch room. Oh, I see a down. I see a descent. This is a 171. This is a heavier climb than the last one. Just shorter.
More coffee is needed.
You're telling me. I need alcohol at this point. Oh, thank you very much, Mr. Zer. No, Mr. Sir. Mr. Wiseman. Thank you so much, buddy. I don't have any booze anyway. Yeah, we're still out, we're still not in the orange. And we've not broken anything yet, so we're doing okay. Yeah, jump in, Mel. Jump into any of the rooms, I'll drag you. Some power in. No need for me to turn the engine off just yet. It's taken us a decent length of time for us to get through the Cornish main line, doesn't it? I'm trying to have a bit of a run up at this, I guess. That was loud. Guessing that's Kyle moving about. Fuck yeah! How you doing, Metal?
Connor has joined him.
Hello, hello.
Are you well?
Yeah, not bad. The other day.
Oh, I'm such a muppet. That's me putting revs on and wondering, why aren't I going anywhere? Bloody engine only. Tit. And now I'm only doing 20 mile an hour up a hill. Up a 1 in 64. I wondered about slowing down. Restricting a combination of weight per local axis. Could you not just run two? Or would that still just be far too heavy? Z here. It's me, voice. Metallicana, introduce yourself.
Hello, hello. I am Shadow Taro's other half.
There you go.
There you go, I don't know what else to say.
There you go, Annie. That's the Aussie. Another Aussie. Down under, yeah. Annie said she was ridiculously excited to hear a new to her voice.
Oh, really?
To be fair, I don't think I've ever spoken to my voice, have I? Maybe once, I think.
Yeah. Looking in the CK Discord, there's like a video of like those train surfers. Yeah, why they film it, they're just asking to get arrested at some point.
I was watching some guy the other couple of weeks ago. He was doing the Russian, trying to get from one side of Russia to the other by train surfing. Not train surfing, but like hiding in the carriages and getting through without passports or something like that.
Yeah.
Trying to get to Chernobyl. It was, watching it was like, it was interesting to see how he was like camping and everything, because he was free camping the whole way through with like a small backpack or whatever, which is, that part of it is, you know, pretty good. But the fact that you have to hide inside a train so people can't see you, that part of it was like, right, okay.
It's a lot of effort.
It is. Yeah. It's so much effort. I mean, here I am being a typical Aussie going, mate, just chuck it on the back of my ute, go for a drive.
Yeah, right. That's the exact thing about having a car, you just go and do something, don't you? But, yeah, you sat on a train, you can't quite do that. It was probably the same guy who went across Russia in a coal train, I think it was, wasn't it? He jumped onto a coal
that's
train.
The one?
Is it the same guy, yeah?
That's the same guy.
Yeah, he makes a career out of it.
Mm-hmm. Is that the same guy that got banned from Canada?
Oof. Maybe. The one guy who did Montreal's Vancouver. Oh, they got it. It was probably that same guy, yeah.
You know, the one that did Montreal to Vancouver and went to go back, got to the Canadian border. Canadian, of course, they'd watched his YouTube channel, realised that what he'd done was illegal, arrested him at the border and said, basically, you're getting back on the plane, you're going home again. You're banned from entering the country.
Gutted.
Hey, free ride home. Not bad.
Yeah.
No, had to pay for the ride home.
You didn't say that.
That's fucking spoil sports.
That or thrown in prison.
Border control stopped him very politely and asked him to get back on the next flight. Oh yeah, there you go then, DV.
Another episode of Banged Up Abroad.
What did you do, rode a train?
Yeah.
Yeah, literally, as Nico Diva said, his choice was go back on the next flight or be arrested and it would be a prison sentence.
Yeah, and it would have been
that. It's considered that date because it's that dangerous, it's considered that illegal in Canada.
Yeah. I don't know how it is in America, not the United States. I guess you
get under exactly the same in the United States. It's illegal to do that in the United States as well.
Yeah, most likely would be thrown in prison.
You'd be pretty stupid to do that here. You'd be pretty stupid to do that here in Australia.
Yeah. You'd be pretty stupid to do it here. So
train
just...
track.
It's virtually a rarity here in the UK.
Yeah, you don't see people jumping on the top of trains because you just get scraped off on a tunnel.
And plus most of our network is overhead wires anyway, so it's almost impossible.
In the US they just shoot him, yeah, probably.
I don't think they'll just shoot him, they'd probably get...
No, but they would. That's dangerous to all the people. Bang, shot.
He's got a weapon and shot. He didn't have a weapon. Puts gun next to him. Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
A At least that's how it happens in the movies. I'm not saying that that's how it happens in real life. I'm saying that's how it happens in the movies.
But yeah. Probably get a lecture about rail safety in a lift to the nearest Greyhound.
Or if he just refused, he'd be in the next another.
Yes, Alfie, we've done two trains since.
Because I don't know if you ever heard of the National Geographic show Banged Up Abroad.
Yeah, have you?
Would have made another episode of that show.
You'd not see anyone do from London to Cardiff, would you? Oh, yeah, no, yeah, you wouldn't see anyone jump, you know. Here I am on top of a 43. It would be loud.
If you were going to go from east to west in the UK by train, how long would it actually take?
Well, the Cornish... Well, if you went from Penzance to... Say you went from Penzance to Ipswich, Norwich, around that way. Should I have a look, actually? Hang on.
It's 6 hours from Penzance to Paddington. Well, no, it's close to 5.5 hours.
Yeah, it's another 2 hours, I think, up to Norwich, isn't it?
Yeah. And to do the Aberdeen to Penzance run on a voyage, it's a 12-hour trip.
Yeah, if you do it from Aberdeen to... you can do it from Aberdeen to Penzance, can't you? Which I think is the longest train... Yeah. I'm surprised it doesn't go from Inverness, you know.
Longest continuous train journey in the UK.
Yeah. So if I was to do... Well, it's further away, Norwich, I guess, isn't it? Penzance to Norwich. Eight hours 23, 8 hours 17. So yeah, about 8 hours is what we were saying. So yeah, 8 hours, 10 minutes,
and
that.
Fair enough. And that's by train, right? Not by car.
Yeah, it's by train, yeah.
Yeah.
The Caledonian Sleeper. The Inverness one, not the Fort William or Edinburgh one. It'd be Inverness to London, innit?
Yeah.
But the route from Aberdeen to Penzance is still longer.
Yeah, the longest continuous train journey in the UK is Aberdeen to Penzance. It is not the Caledonian Sleeper.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying.
The longest by time is the Caledonian Sleeper.
But it's because it's the Sleeper.
The longest distance is continuous distance is Aberdeen to Penzance.
Why does the Paddington Penzance Sleeper not take, 5 hours? Why is that a sleeper?
Because the whole point is it travels at 75 miles an hour maximum. The whole point is that people wake up in London refreshed. They get a full night's sleep on the train and they wake up in London refreshed. You don't get booted. It gets into London at 5 o'clock in the morning. You don't get, if you're a sleeper passenger, you don't get booted off the train till 7 o'clock.
Oh, so you could just sit on the train asleep for 2 hours, could you?
Yeah.
Solid.
And the reason you get kicked off at 7 o'clock is because they need to clear platform one to take the train. They take the train to Old Oak Common, or I think it's now down to Reading Train Care Depot.
That's a long way to go.
Well, Old Oak Common doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah, because they replaced it with North Pole, didn't they?
Yeah, North Pole. Actually, it may go to North Pole.
No, it's Reading. Goes to
rain, very wet everywhere tomorrow night.
Because they're North Poles for the IETs.
So bloody hell. And it gets dragged back in of an evening.
Yeah.
Yeah, Reading. I'm saying Reading. Reading train care.
But yeah, you got to think there's layover stops on the Penzance Sleeper. It spends 2 hours at Exeter on the down. Oh, I did say Reading Train Care Depot first.
How do, Reggie? You well, buddy? Welcome to the last 15 miles of the Cornish Main Line. We might actually finish before midnight, Rob.
Yeah.
For the record, the dispatcher had us in Penzance now. Have I got any more oncoming AI, or have they all gone?
They're all gone.
Yeah.
Hmm. It might be worth putting in a few more. Delaying it back slightly.
No, I reckon I could do it faster than you.
Fucking it, right, okay, that's a challenge. Right, fair enough. Well, that's fine.
It'll be faster than Wipeouts or Bust will be the title of the stream.
Not exactly gone in 60 seconds, is it? Bear in mind, this is my first like full run of it. When you do it, it has to be your first full run of the of this scenario. Bear in mind, you have seen it and everything now, so you kind of know what's going on. What's new, Edgy? What's new, mate? So that's the launch of the site for HS2 TV. Oh, okay. Is that what they're doing with Old Oak, is it? Fair enough.
Were they demolishing Old Oaks Common to make way for HS2?
Yeah, that's what Divas just said.
Yeah.
Thought the station got cancelled. I thought the station got cancelled.
Yeah. Oh. So they're just doing it straight. So they're going the more direct route if they're doing that.
No, the depot's still going to be there, but I think the station got cancelled as part of the plans because it was overrunning.
Yeah. I thought they're just doing it as a depot for Crossrail.
This terminal, alright. For both services, turned up at 5. Got it. What's your favourite train, Jack?
Yeah, I think Euston would have been... Euston is just a very poor choice. I think Paddington would have been a better choice. You could just run it directly in.
No room at Paddington.
Yeah, say Paddington's full, innit?
You've got Crossrail. There's absolutely no room at Paddington.
Now, once Crossrail opens, that'll free up some space.
No. Crossrail takes up the rest of the space. There is no room at London Paddington to run HS2 in.
Same at Euston, there's no room at Euston.
No, Euston, you take some of the platforms out of service for normal trains.
And you do that, you got a load of chaos.
I get it, Edgy. Exactly, I get it with deliveries all the time.
Yeah. Plus, you've got a factor, you've got London Northwestern, London Overground. Take out what, especially if you're taking platform 15, then you only got one platform that will fit the cabby sleeper. That's
going to
be a problem.
Can help. Hello, everyone. Can I just take a minute for everyone? Say hello to Mr. Cyanide. He ain't dead yet. Good to see you, buddy.
They just connected it.
Go on, Metal, shout loud. Kyle, give us a minute. Go on, Metal, shout loud.
Shout loud? What do you mean, shout loud?
Say hello to Cyanide, he's just had an operation.
Oi!
Good to
what
see you.
Getting a punch up in a pub or something.
Yeah, he walked up to a guy in the middle of the hall and just like threw it, like some guy walked up to him acting all like hard man. This guy was like 3 times his size and he proper like nailed him. He's hard man of the North, Cyanide is.
Well, if that's true then, well done.
Every waking moment is agony.
Okay, just to put a perspective for everybody here too, as probably as high as my voice might be, I am a 6'3", 160 kilo giant.
I'm about the same. I'm exactly that. Yeah.
Yeah. So you can imagine what happened when I was walking around London with Shadow, who's much shorter than I am. And I walk into a pub and almost hit my head on the doorway as I walk in, and everyone stare at me like I'm freaking like some WWE superstar that's, you know, 10 times the size of everybody else.
God, the looks I used to get. Especially on the freaking subway in London. That was hilarious. Oh, I'm just going to take the subway to go and see Shadow because she's finished work. And then I'll hop on the subway and my head is literally on my shoulder and touching the roof of the subway. And people look at me like I'm some kind of freak. And I'm like, I'm just a typical Aussie. We're all this tall.
This is, that's fair. Even my Australian friend, when he came over, he was like, Jesus, you're tall. Because I'm 6'3" and about the same weight. And he made a point. He stood there, looked up at me, and went, "Fuck."
I am not fucking with you.
Well, the thing is, my girlfriend's 4'11", so it makes for some pretty comical looks when we're out in town or whatever, and everyone's just like,
"Well, see, Shadow's not that short either. She's like 5'10", 5'11", so she's pretty average height."
Yeah, well, that is not far off average. Yeah, Amber's 4'11". How are you feeling anyway, Cyanide, apart from quoting Age of Empires? Hopefully are you still feeling a bit woozy, or are you back with the world now? I told your mum to make you a curry, and while you were still a bit wheezy, tell you that what's just gone on was in the curry, and she said I was being harsh. But good to see you. Good to see you, Sam. I'm glad you're up and well, buddy. I'm glad that it went as well as it did from what mum told me. So I'm good to see you. But Cyanide, now that you might have some time before you can go like running about and you've been fully conscious. Were you conscious when they did the op? I didn't fancy that. I wouldn't fancy that. You're a braver man than I, sir. So harsh, yeah, funny. There's a difference between harsh and funny. Alright, fair enough. Well, we said now while you might be slightly immobile, you've got to ramp up your streams now. That's it. You've got to like ramp up your mum's energy bill. And
yeah, spend all your mum's money on the PC and the streaming.
I want your internet provider turning around and saying that you're using too much.
Well, there we go. I just worked out how long it's going to take. Sorry, the reason I was asking my question before too about how long it's going to take to get from one side to the other is if I was to leave where we are in Sydney and head to Darwin, which is in the very north centre of Australia, it takes 42 hours by train to get there.
That'd be an XPT as well, wouldn't it? Be one of our 125s, what converted?
No, it'd be a, don't know what they call them, but the specific engine used in the cross-country services, not the XPT. XPT Suburban Services, isn't it?
They call it the Union Pacific. And it has a couple of ways of getting across too, so you got Sydney all the way up through Queensland, the centre point on the map for the different states we have between Queensland, New South Wales and Northern Territory and up. Or the other way, which a lot of people do, is from Sydney to Melbourne to Adelaide, then straight up the centre. But the trains themselves, I think they're the XPTs.
Hmm. Cool, good fun. Well, I'm glad that you're up and home anyway, Cyanide. So hope to see you on. Hope to see you kicking about. All right, lad. Sorry, Kyle. Go on. You can crack on now. I just wanted to say that while Cyanide was here, as he has just undergone surgery.
As I was saying, if they close. They end up closing some of the platforms that you used to. There is going to be a lot of problems.
Well, they're going to. Nico Diva said they're going to double deck Houston.
Oh, make it like.
If they take some of the platforms out to do the works, that's still going to cause problems.
Make it like St. Pancras, then, couldn't they do it that way?
Yeah, with a station as busy as Houston, that's not going to work.
You don't know that. There you go, platform 17 and 18 are gone. Not that they were much use anyway.
It's like platforms 15 and that. Which are the only ones long, which is, I think that one, is it one of the ones used by the Caledonian Sleeper?
Take out the Caledonian Sleeper platform and move the Caledonian Sleeper to King's Cross.
Yeah.
And do it in two parts.
Yeah, bear in mind.
Close one through.
King's Cross won't be able to fit the full Caledonian Sleeper set.
I said you split it into two parts. You have to basically. Because one will cross over back over one way, and one will go direct up to.
And the platform 1 and platform 15 can't go because they're only too long enough to accommodate the Cali.
The Mark 5, the only locos that work with them are electric bits, class 92s. And if they're going direct up the east coast, they tend to cause problems with the overheads.
That's true because of the overheads on the east coast.
Yeah. The 331s and the 92s are in the same power bracket. But that and probably like an IET in the same block that caused them to trip out. I think that's something that happens at Preston as well.
If there's
a 331 heading from Blackpool and the Cali Sleeper's in the block, they'll have to hold the Cali Sleeper to let the 331 pass.
Oh, the joys of overhead electrics.
Yeah. I'm kind of trying to make a drawing of a Class 85.
Yeah, why, Diva? I never quite understood it, if I'm honest. Taking an AC current and convert it DC. The only thing I can imagine is that, of course, AC is like using petrol, whereas DC is like using diesel. The only thing I can imagine is that they're just that much torquier.
I think they're more efficient.
AC is more efficient. AC is more efficient. In the last 30 years, the control systems AC those powers have been viable. Ah, right. Yeah, because you know, I imagine you had to have like, some whopping big transformers in them at the time, whereas now that could be more compact, I guess. This will be where we go down to a single track for our approaching to Penzance. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Don't you wait a long rock.
Yeah, just about to hit the 50 mile an hour.
Which has no point accelerating back up to the 75 after, up to the 70 afterwards, because you're going straight into a 15.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just
catch you out.
Maybe that's what it wants you to think. But it's great being stood on the beach there and watching all this.
Oh, come on, that's not a beach.
It is in the UK.
Golden Sands, Perranporth, known for its surfing, is its new key. Prepare for AWS warning.
Yeah, I've already tabbed the red signal ahead. It's a dodgy one, isn't it? So there you go, bear in mind it's nearly 6 o'clock in the sim. Look, there's light traffic, there's a 150 there in the carriage wash and... some Mark 3's chilling here on the right side.
Adding song requests at the end of the stream.
Might get another quick scenario in. Who knows? I'm buzzing. I'm about to celebrate this.
You got it all the way. You completed Ben's challenge. If it dumps now, I'll qualify it as completed because it's not going to overheat if we get to Penzance.
Learn from your mistakes. Let's just F2 that one real quick.
Hey, I didn't make the mistake. I F2'd before I did
what. No, but you're trying to do what you're trying to do what I did to you. Watch it crash now.
Troll mode has been activated.
I fucking did as well. Literally said
he did it to me on the charity stream.
He was doing a 24-hour charity stream, but he did it in 2 12-hours, and one of them was Penzance, the where we're pulling into now, up to Edinburgh. And he was just you went far from it. You were about 2/3 of the way through, weren't you?
Yeah.
And 2/3 of the way through, and he went, oh, I'll save it here. Now I put in the chat, I went, watch it crash now, and then it just went, dunk, stopped. And it was like, blame wipeouts. Everyone was like, blame wipeouts. I was like, sorry.
Yep.
Is this platform going to be long enough for this?
Should fit within the signal block.
Oh, yeah, the signal block's fucking huge. Look at, oh, right, that signal block. Oof. Just caught that. Little fucking shunt signal chilling on the floor there.
Wet roots into platform 2.
Yeah, sends me into the HST.
Noot noot.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you should fit within the signal block as long as you go right up to the buffer.
Oh, I plan to. Oh no, if you listen to 3-2-3s, you get the distinctive as it changes up through like a 17-speed gearbox.
Yeah.
That's ridiculous. Oh,
and Frost 323 is actually run on my local line as well.
I thought Northern are the only people who really run them now.
Yeah, West Mids also have them. They've been running the cross city line since it was electrified in the mid-90s.
That was after, that happened after a councillor took his own life because of he was being investigated for fraud and stuff. And he was the councillor that had proposed it and was supposed to be seeing it through to the end. And yeah, it went. And so they were like, oh, shall we do it? Shall we not do it? So they did it anyway. But it was exactly that, that 323s were... we'll be getting the rest of the 323s. All right. It was exactly them. It was Manchester Metro... Manchester... Was it Transport for Greater Manchester or something? And the Birmingham Cross City Lines that were... It was designed and made for.
Yeah. Surprisingly enough, there were meant to be some for West Yorkshire, but that never happened because of privatisation.
Oh, like a fucking glove. Disgusting, you stuffed yourself with bread. Hey, perfectly. I'd have done exactly the same thing. That.
Perfectly in the platform.
Dunk.
Yeah. Oh, beautiful parking there, buddy.
That is.
You ain't going to get much closer than that.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Ding, ding, ding.
No, 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 you ain't seen nothing yet.
Thank you very much for watching this journey from Plymouth to Penzance. As you can see, we made it without the Class 40 blowing up any of its traction motors. If you do choose to give this a go yourself, there's a link down below to the UK Train Sim forum. And as ever, any feedback or criticism is always appreciated. That can be given either via the stream, link also below, or the Discord that you'll find linked on the Twitch page. Any other questions or anything else, please drop a comment below and it'd be lovely to hear from you. But thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed that. Have a good day.